Hi, welcome to the video, Simplifying Expressions with Function Notation. Recall that in previous algebra courses, simplifying expression means that you're changing some expression so that there are no parentheses, you're combining like terms, you're simplifying fractions. In the case when you're working with exponents, you don't have any negative exponents in the expression. Things like that. And this list will keep growing as you encounter more algebra or learn more algebraic techniques. So we're going to specifically talk about simplifying expressions with functions. So using functions, we're going to, for example, plug in or simplify the expression f of negative x. So instead of evaluating at a specific point like f of 2, we're now, what happens if our input is negative x? So we have f of x is equal to x squared minus 2x plus 5. So we're going to look at f of negative x. So in wherever I see an x in my function, I'm going to replace it with negative x. So I have x squared, so that becomes parentheses negative x. It's always an extremely important thing that when you are evaluating functions that you use parentheses when you are substituting in your input value. So negative x squared minus 2, and then I have another x, so I'm going to replace that with a negative x plus 5. So we want to simplify this, which means that we're going to get rid of parentheses and combine like terms. Negative x squared, that is negative x times negative x, which becomes positive x squared. Minus 2 times negative x would be plus 2x plus 5. And I cannot combine any like terms. So that is my simplified expression. F of negative x is equal to x squared plus 2x plus 5. In this next problem, find and simplify negative f of x. The negative is outside f of x. So the input isn't negative. The output is actually negative. So it is negative of what f of x is. So if my function f of x is x squared plus minus 2x plus 5, I want negative of that function. So that's the difference between this. The input here is negative x. Here, we want negative of f of x. So I am going to change this to red. I want negative of this expression. So here we have the negative in blue. And again, this is another maybe color coding video if you want to take notes in different colors. I'm going to replace f of x with what we know our function to be. And I want negative of the whole function, so I have to put it in parentheses. X squared minus 2x plus 5. We don't want just negative of the first term, we want negative of the whole function. So, following my, if I'm going to simplify, I have to get rid of parentheses. So in this case, I want to use the distributive property to distribute negative 1 throughout, so that it would be negative x squared plus 2x minus 5. So negative of f of x is equal to negative x squared plus 2x minus 5. So look at how these functions are similar, but if I'm substituting my input, if my input's negative x, then I'm replacing all of the x's. If the input is x, I don't replace x. It's negative of what the function is. F of x is representing, is the same. That red part here is the same as this. That's the difference between those two. In this next problem, we have g of x is equal to x over x plus 3. So in these two problems, they look similar. Let's look at both of them before we try either. So in the first one, we want to simplify g of negative 2x. That means my input is negative 2x. Here, I want to simplify negative 2 times g of x. So here, I'm multiplying my whole function by negative 2, whereas In the first problem, my input is actually negative 2x. So let's try this. G of negative 2x means that my anywhere I see x in my original function, I'm going to replace that with negative 2x. So here I have negative 2x over negative 2x plus 3. Well, the numerator cannot be simplified, and the denominator is just negative 2x plus 3. And that is simple, that is in simplified form. It might be tempting right now for those of you who have a little bit more, might recall from a previous algebra class that it looks like these two values might cancel out, but they do not. So I think that's in upcoming sections we'll talk about that this cannot be simplified. This is it. In the next problem, instead of my input being negative 2x, I'm now looking at negative 2 times g of x. Negative 2 times the whole function. And my whole function, g of x, is x plus 3. So I'm going to write negative 2, and then we're going to replace g of x with x over x plus 3. So how do I simplify this? Well, this is a an integer times a fraction. So I'm going to put that over 1 times x over x plus 3. And then I'm going to multiply across. So that's negative 2 times x is negative 2x. 1 times x plus 3 is just x plus 3. And so that is negative 2 times g of x. In our last example, we have h of x is equal to x minus x squared. And let's look at our two problems that we're going to explore. We're going to look at what the difference is between h of x minus 4 versus h of x minus 4. So h of x minus 4 means our input into the function. Wherever I see x, I'm going to replace it with x minus 4. So we have x minus 4, okay, that comes from our first x, minus parentheses x minus 4 squared. So kind of note, I have two different places where I'm replacing my input. So here's my input, x minus 4. So here's the first place, x minus 4, and here's x minus 4 squared. So I'm replacing that. So now we need to simplify. X minus 4, there's nothing being multiplied in front, so I can get rid of those parentheses. And then we have minus, and then we have x minus 4 squared. So recall that this is x minus 4 times x minus 4. That is, and we also have this negative, so I'm going to put this in. I'm just going to work on this bit. I need to simplify this. I'm going to put that in bracket because I have not yet distributed this negative. So x minus 4 times x minus 4 is x squared minus 4x minus 4x plus 16. And if you were thinking, man, that she's doing that the long way, and you remember that this is really x squared minus 8x plus 16, that you can double that 4 and make that 8, and then square the 4 and make that 16. That's awesome. We might have had a long little break here, and so let's get this worked out. Now, excuse me, I still have to distribute that negative sign through here. So x minus 4 minus x squared plus 8x minus 16, and now we need to combine like terms. We should start with our highest exponent leading for the leading term, so that's negative x squared. We have x and 8x, which makes positive 9x, and negative 4 and negative 16 make negative 20. So h of x minus 4 simplifies to x squared plus 9x minus 20. If I did all the algebra right. If not, please email me. All right, find and simplify h of x minus 4. Now this means that it's the function, I'm going to take the function, I'm just going to subtract 4 from it. So we have h of x, and I'm just going to subtract 4 from that function. So what is my function? It's that bit, h of x is, I'm replacing with x minus x squared, and then I simply want to subtract 4 from the function. All right, so writing this in standard notation, let's start with our highest exponent, so negative x squared plus x minus 4. So we say h of x minus 4 is negative x squared plus x minus 4. So a couple for you to try. We're going to let f of x be the function 3x squared minus 2x plus 1. I want you to simplify these for these four expressions. F of negative x, number 2, negative f of x, number 3, f of x plus 5, and the last one, 5 f of x plus 2. Sorry, that ran off of that box. Again, that's 5 f of x plus 2. So try those before moving on to the next video and bring those answers to class.